It's Madden NFL 24, where we'll see teams who have been division rivals since 1961. It's the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles, and it's coming up next.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. And they'll be led out by a guy who has a couple years under his belt in the NFL, their third-year quarterback.
If you ask coaches at any level to design their ideal leader of a team, I think they're going to check every box with this guy. He's got the poise to handle responsibility. He stays calm under any kind of pressure, and he brings out the best of his teammates each and every week.
To the outside, this is complete to Jackson. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with McCoy. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A 3-yard loss. 4th down now. So much for picking it up on the ground on 3rd down. 3rd play of the drive, and this defense showing strong early.
I wonder how much of that was scouting. I wonder how much of that was a gut feeling like, okay, let's just go ahead and sell out here and get after them, thinking they're going to run the football and stuff them early. Because they've now set the tone. They've set a precedent right here that if you're going to try and run the ball against us, it could be hard going throughout this game.
The Eagles send out their punter now. He'll kick it away after a 3 and out on the opening drive of the game. Fielded just inside the 20. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And it will be Vikings ball, 1st and 10. So now we'll get a look at the other offensive unit as they come out for their first possession. And they will be led out by the youngster, the rookie, their QB.
His ability to adjust on the fly is almost unmatched in the game right now, because it leads to a couple of snaps per game where you just sit back and ask yourself, how did he pull that off? Opponents can practice and prepare each and every week all they want, but this guy, he is hard to corral.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. They start the drive with Peterson. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Early down stuff will put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
From the 32-yard line now, here's a second and nine. They'll drop to throw. Middle of the field to Jefferson.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on draft routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
2 yards still to go. Third down now. Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
The Vikings send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. It's a 45-yard punt, just a 1 yard return. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. He'll start on the ground with McCoy. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Out of the gun here, it's Cunningham. Going to drop this off to McCoy, complete. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on first down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Cunningham looking to throw. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Call it a loss of 4 there on the sack. And speaking of the number 4, it brings up 4th down now.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. The Vikings taking the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's 2nd down.
I tell you what, that's a veteran play from a guy in his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to force something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from the 35. They'll look to throw here, and they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
This defense has passed its first 2 tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know there's probably another throw coming on 3rd down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
The threat of a 2nd straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. He'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. So they've got the football, and they'll start right on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. And a defensive-minded coach loves to turn up the heat, turns it up there, it pays off.
And back in the good old days, those defensive-minded coaches just talked about intimidating teams, using force, right, beating them to the punch. In this case, they're talking about creating turnovers. That's all they preach all game long, all practice long, every meeting. Get the football. That's what they want.
Following the fumble recovery, Cunningham out to his, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Cunningham to throw. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
That's a sharp throw right there on third down. They're looking to get the first points of the game, and they certainly don't want to be on a field goal. So that's a nice job to get the hookup and set up a first and goal.
Now McCoy. Nifty move. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of four.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Second and goal from the one. They'll try again. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Eagles use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one.
Sometimes offenses can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive spanned five plays, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Vikings ready to go again on offense. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up first and 10. Here's Peterson as they begin on the ground. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. Well, you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Just need a yard here, second and 1. They'll set up to throw. Throw right side, going to be complete to Moss. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. First time they've hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll try the middle with Peterson. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Defensively, they were in the 3-4. Solid run up the middle. What made it successful?
Well, what you have to do is control the nose guard, but sometimes you don't do it by blocking him. You do it by influencing him. Get him moving to one side or the other and hit him back on the opposite.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Looking to throw. Short throw into the hands of Jordan. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the raw potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Third down and one. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown. A great play there. 27 yards. And the Vikings are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Those are the touchdowns that aren't just scored on Sundays or on Monday night. Those are the ones that are scored during the week because they had that preparation in a great route run.
Oh, I love that observation, because you don't just roll out on game day and say, okay, go run this route and let's get it done. That means exactly what you said. The practice had to occur beforehand, which led to the timing, which led to the touchdown.
Point after, right down the middle, and we are tied at 7. That drive goes 80 yards in 6 plays, and it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. He's past the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Eagles.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from his special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times when they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
You're exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules. And if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
Extra point attempt to come here. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. And no doubt one of the most, if not the most exciting play we'll see in this game, the kick return all the way to the end zone for 6 points. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. Cordarrelle Patterson to return it, bringing it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Minnesota's offense takes over possession.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 32 on the play.
And this is how you answer a touchdown the other end. You come out throwing to start your own drive. And not just throwing, but pushing it down the field. And they come up with a big play as they try to answer back with a score of their own.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now a give to Peterson running right. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. He finds his man complete. It's Moss. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. And that is no good. And this will stay at a 7-point game.
Well, Brandon, anything beyond 50, you start rolling the dice a bit. And once you get up around 57, 58 yards, the chances of making it go down dramatically. And sure enough, this one winds up no good.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. The drive will start with an option going left. Breaks a tackle, and he's down right around midfield after a gain of 2, maybe 3.
Typically on the read option play, when we talk about responsibilities, we're talking about what the quarterback has to go through. How about the inside linebacker, though? His job on this play, shadow the quarterback and hold him to a short gain. Did it to perfection.
He'll decide to keep this once more. Now Cunningham has the ball knocked down. And the Vikings. And now off to the races, down the right side. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
He was having success there holding on to it on the option, but ultimately problems downfield, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, and this is a tough one because you know you'd prefer to have your quarterback either heading to the sidelines or getting down at the end of the play. But you've got an aggressive one. He's fighting for extra yardage, and he gets stripped there. You don't need him to be a hero in that situation. You want your quarterback taking care of himself.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They run over center with Peterson. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game
then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Now they show jet sweep, but instead a run up the middle here.
And he'll get about three as he's brought down to the 28.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Now the Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10.
So the fumble recovery had him set up in ideal field position, but they can muster only 3 points out of it.
Yeah, when you're able to force turnovers, especially when it results in field position like they had, you really want to make it hurt. Here, they take the field goal. That's definitely not what they were hoping for.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. Jackson now to return. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they get set to start their drive with a first and 10. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it. Down the numbers, there he goes! And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down. Pretty explosive run on that inside handoff, and when you're a runner of his caliber, you don't need a big crease.
You really don't, but also what we're seeing is an offensive line that's taking charge at the point of attack, aren't we? Not only are they controlling the initial contact, they're actually utilizing what they call the strain the next 2 to 3 seconds to continue to move people.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
On second down, it's McCoy. And he'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. And they'll keep it on the ground with McCoy. And the ball is knocked out. But it looks like one of the DBs has it. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
And now out comes Minnesota. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it.
Yeah, quick throw there. It is incomplete.
So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He finds his man complete. It's Moss. They get six. That'll leave them with third and 4. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Back to throw here. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Vikings first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6.
I got kicked out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Just a gain of a couple there, and it'll be second down. Now back to throw. He'll dump this off to Cook. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it'll leave him with third and a full yard to go. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a first down. Instead, it's fourth.
And based on my math, they've only converted one time thus far in this game. So you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
And this one will not get there. Talk to the left anyway. It's no good, and that will keep this a 4-point game. So make it 2 missed field goals for him now, but I have the sense, given that distance, you can probably forgive him here on this one.
Yeah, this is out of the range of just about anybody on planet Earth, except probably you, partner. But you just got to drive it out low and hope that somehow you hit it absolutely perfect. But no real chance for this one to go through.
Two sides to every coin. This is the bad side of missing the 58-yarder. Now they start at the 48. Now a first down throw, Cunningham. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
Now a quick slant as the throw's complete.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Cunningham.
He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And the Vikings now heading onto the field.
And the way their last drive ended, boy, it was frustrating. They had a pretty good drive going. It was sustained, and then it stalled out, Charles, and they missed the field goal and got nothing out of it.
Is that insult to injury? Because they had such a sustained drive, as you noted. So you know for the head coach, it almost felt like a little bit of failure to send out the field goal unit and then to not even see the ball go through the post. What a bummer on that last drive for them. Got to pick themselves up from that.
Taking it right down Broadway. He's on his way. Touchdown, Vikings. A great effort there. 77 yards. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again.
and again.
It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
Point after here coming up. It's good, and they'll take a 17-14 lead. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. And out now come the Eagles. And Charles, a very uninspired effort the last time we saw them out there. It was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now? It's letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
On first and 10, Cunningham. And his throw is incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Now Cunningham. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Boy, that was certainly well read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
They'll come up facing third and 5.
Here's Cunningham. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have an Eagles first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on third down and 5.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open. He finds a way to pick up a first down.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Cunningham looking to throw. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
So that now 4 first half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's a game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Now Cunningham. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Looking to throw, Cunningham. And that will be incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. Fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 15-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And they will take over first and 10.
There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's already cruised past the 100-yard mark. We haven't even gone away for halftime yet.
He might not want halftime. All right, why cool off?
Keep everybody here.
Let's stay out on the field and keep going. But all that being said, everything is really working well for them. The play calling's been excellent. The blocking's been terrific. And obviously his vision and legs have hurdled him to this big number so far. We could be seeing something really special here.
And we'll see how much they give him the ball here. And he'll wind up getting this to the 32. A play that started at the 16, and that's how many yards they get. First down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, they'll throw. And he's got this to Jefferson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 18 yards the gain for number 18.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
Back to throw now on first down. He finds his man complete. It's Jordan. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball got to the receiver. Separates him from the catch. And normally, he's a sure-handed target.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll look to throw again. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And they're able to add on to their advantage.
In the second quarter and already his second touchdown reception.
Absolutely the definition of a difference maker here in this first half. Clearly one of his quarterback's favorite targets.
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. That time a 6-play drive, and it's polished off by a Viking score. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. This fielded right at the goal line. Oh, some strong running. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. They're down now 24-14. Work to do as they come up on a first and 10. Cunningham to throw. He finds McCoy. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. He felt the pressure coming there. That was a good job of just making something out of nothing, so to speak.
Yeah, took the hit and still made the play. You know, when we talk about runners, all right, and on running plays, runs after contact, we call that getting dirty yards, tough, gritty ones. To me, that's like the version of a dirty pass. He knows he's going to get smacked, yet still delivers the football and picks up good yardage.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. They're rocking and rolling, but the scoreboard doesn't show a big difference. You know, maybe it's one of those games where coaches say you can't miss your turn on offense.
I like the way you phrased it, especially with that. I love that rocking and rolling because the explosions on offense are happening. So that's going to get the crowd going. They're loving that. But defensively, they just can't get it together to get the stops they've needed in order to help increase their margin. They've got to find a way, but you're not counting on it. Exactly what you said. Can't miss your turn, can't miss your opportunity.
Yeah, they're going for another opportunity now.
Right up to that point, I was about to say, he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches. Now a throw here, hauled in. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third and 9 here. Looking to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Short throw into the hands of Jordan.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And that's going to bring up second down.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end.
Second and 7.
Back to throw again.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Again, he'll drop to throw.
And he is caught.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 41-yard line. A gain of 18 and a new set of downs.
But things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. On first down, he'll drop to throw.
And a dangerous throw there on the drop-off. Incomplete, nearly intercepted.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets 2 more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. They'll set up to throw.
This one brought in by Jefferson.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. 18 yards the gain for number 18. Now the Vikings will use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. They'll look to throw here on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jordan. So the completion good for 7 there, and that will bring up 2nd down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Here's 2nd and 3.
He'll look to throw. And this one is incomplete.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's got to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, just a 32-yard attempt. And his kick is indeed good, and that will do it for this first half. So we hit halftime with our visitors, the Vikings, taking the lead to the locker room. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number 3.
The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half.
Taken at the goal line.
And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third.
But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Peterson. So no gain on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
A 10th carry now for Peterson.
And only a couple there as he'll take this up to the 47. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, we may not see it behind the big play sheet that they like to use, but I'll bet there's a big grin on the defensive coordinator's face. A corner blitz, what we often call a cat blitz. Usually they disguise it, Brandon. You're up on a receiver. It looks like you're going to bump and run with him, press coverage, and then he just takes off straight for the quarterback and someone comes behind him to pick up the receiver.
And as a former member of the secondary, it makes you happy too, doesn't it?
I can't lie about it. I've got a big grin on my face too. That was a heck of a play, a heck of a call.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Following the fumble recovery, Cunningham. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
I am willing to bet that he got a monster grin on his face when he saw what was happening. Man covers were so committed to denying a big throw that it pulled attention away from him, and he had an easy lane to hit, and hit it he did.
Operating from the gun, Cunningham to the end zone, but it's incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
Tenth carry now for McCoy. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted but it winds up falling incomplete. So now fourth and goal. You're trailing by a decent amount here. What are you doing, Coach Davis?
Well, I've got to think to myself, just how many more opportunities am I going to have this close and have this chance? I've got to go for it right here. The clock's dwindling on me. Let's go get it done.
And his kick is right there. It's good, and that gets him back within 10.
So they got the turnover, started with great field position, but in the end, the defense able to hold firm, and they only get 3 out of it.
And I like what you said right there, that defense able to hold firm, backed up into the shadow of their own end zone. Goalpost right behind them. They had to make sure they didn't give up the 6, and boy, they came through in a big way. To them, even though they gave up 3, that's a win for their side.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away.
Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Minnesota's offense takes over possession.
And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They'll fake it on the jet sweep, and instead a handoff up the middle. And this will be a Vikings first down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to the ground, this time Cook. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
From the 46, here's second and 2.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Swinging this out wide here for Cook.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
First down, here's a run with Peterson. And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. He'll drop to throw.
Throw over the middle, caught by Jordan.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 35. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. That's going to be caught by Moss. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 23 yards on the play. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. 12 more yards there and another first down.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just needed the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Foreman will score. Touchdown, Vikings.
And maybe that's the magic touch right there. They didn't use him at all in the first half, at least running the football. But here they entrust him with some work down in the red zone, and he responds. One carry, one touchdown.
No going for two. They'll kick the point after. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. A good drive that time as they go nine plays in all. And it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The Eagles just about set to go to work on offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
45 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Now a pass hauled in downfield. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one good for 26 and a first down. They've been struggling in the passing game. Do you like the aggressiveness there? I mean, it worked on that play, but do you like it?
I do, because a lot of the time you're struggling because your passing lanes are clogged. That usually happens when you're throwing the ball underneath. People start to press up on you. Push them deep. Find some space and open things up again. Being aggressive there, I think, will pay off for them.
Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. Ooh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
Still first down.
The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Now Cunningham. Going to throw right side here, complete. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
From the 21, here's second down and 3.
Now an inside give to McCoy. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Out of the gun here, it's Cunningham. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's McCoy. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. They call it a loss of a yard there. And that's going to make it fourth down.
But looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
And his kick here is good. And that will close the gap down to 14.
So that maybe not exactly what they were hoping for, but it does get them back within a couple of scores.
And at this point in the third quarter, you don't have much margin for error, and that means you can't have drives that end with nothing. Whether it's a punt, a turnover on downs, those have to go away. You have to end with a kick, either a field goal or an extra point after a touchdown.
The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away.
From his end zone, here comes Patterson. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
And now out comes Minnesota. They'll try and start this drive in the air.
Short throw into the hands of Jordan.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Back to throw now on first down.
Short throw into the hands of Jordan.
Yeah, he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
I don't care what sport you're playing. Everyone likes to build up a little momentum, don't they? And look at this. Back-to-back completions to the big target at tight end.
That one not as profitable as the other, but still a decent gain. On second down, Peterson. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
They'll look to throw now on first down. He'll find Thielen working the middle.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
A good pickup there of 20 yards.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Up the middle, it's Peterson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
On play action, they'll throw.
Complete. Jefferson the target.
He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. We have played 3 quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Vikings in possession of the football and the lead. They'll be looking to add to that total as we begin quarter number 4. Back to throw here.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Now a second and 10. Back to throw. That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Now Peterson running right. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
And his kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personneled. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Now a first down throw, Cunningham. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the fourth quarter here, you've held the team under 100 yards passing. You've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Cunningham looking to throw. He'll buy some time right. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there because, to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
On first down, it's Cunningham. And he couldn't get that one to his man. Short of him, it's low and incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
To throw on second down, Cunningham. And he'll check this one down to McCoy. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10. Now they couldn't get anything going there out on the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
Cunningham. That is caught. A big play there for Philly. 44 yards.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet.
and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Up the middle, here's McCoy. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And now it's 3rd and 4.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, they're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is 3rd and 4. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. From 8 yards out. And the Eagles have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Extra point right down the middle, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. So that one, an 8-play drive, it spans 75 yards. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. No return here for Patterson, so they'll begin things at the 25-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's coming together for you. The big guys up front have created space. You've run through it. And you've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. A throw left side to start out. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. They'll set up a throw. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to 3rd down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Vikings 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. They'll look to throw again. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw.
This one brought in by Jefferson.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 30. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
They run with Peterson. He's been busy tonight. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out. We've got them now.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
159 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
To Jefferson on the slant.
Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
Here is 3rd down and 4.
He'll look to throw. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up 4. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. And this one is right through, and that will extend their lead even further.
So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by 2 late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist, but time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. Jackson now to return.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Eagles coming out as they get ready.
For this offense, Charles, remember the last time they were out here, marched it nearly the full length of the football field, and a lot of the attack went through the air, so now they're seeing if they can duplicate that performance.
Okay, if I show my age a little bit, partner, because I can hear my high school coach, John Ford. I can hear his voice in my head. Laddie, when you put the ball in the air, 3 things can happen, and 2 of them are bad. But the way the game's being played now, this is just part of what they do, so I don't think they should change anything at all. They've been dominant. Keep throwing it around.
So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that'll bring up 2nd down. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Cunningham to throw. Right side caught by Jackson. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That's a gain of 13 as they try to whittle away at this 13-point deficit. clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Cunningham from the gun. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Second and 10.
Off play action, it's Cunningham. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
That's multiple times now he's tagged them with a big gain with his legs. Really showing off some nice awareness and the ability to correctly realize when he's got a chance to tuck it and go himself.
On first and 10, Cunningham. Going to drop this off to McCoy. Complete. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's second down. And they're going to speed things up here. On second down, here's Cunningham. This is Ertz on the pitch and catch. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10. The Cunningham's throw taken in here by Jackson.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit. And that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completions, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
Now Cunningham. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
Here's second and a yard.
Now Cunningham. And this is Salek here with a grab.
And the Eagles are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
A give to McCoy. And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1 yard line.
Sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
This is third and goal.
Here's Cunningham. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
No choice but to go. Here's fourth down now.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably... And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed, and in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw, as this play will stand as is. Now for the point after. And the lead will shrink to six. So that one, a 13-play drive in total. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Seconds to play. Everything will come down here to this onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. He'll look to throw. Setting up the screen for Cook. And he will have a Viking first down, and that should be the one that gets him to the finish line. So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. Charles, normally when you see a group score this many points, it's a complete blowout. But instead, they needed every single one of those in this close, high-scoring affair.
And Brandon, I'm still on the edge of my seat after that one, because when you have that much scoring and it still comes down to one possession game at the end, that's not something we see very often. And in this case, these offenses, they brought it. The defenses, they're going to need some work going forward.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com.
from Philadelphia. Good night, everybody.